About a year ago, I created some videos about my no work or low work composting system that involved composting my yard waste and my chicken bedding in trash cans. Today, I'm going to finally update you on what I've learned and how that project has progressed. Stay tuned for that, coming up. About a year ago, I set out to find a composting solution that worked for me, in my context. Yes, I know there's a lot of ways to compost out there, from vermicomposting to bokashi to active aerobic composting. They all have their pluses and they all have their minuses. And I was trying to find a system that really worked best for me in my context. That meant for me, I wanted to be able to compost everything that I had, kitchen scraps and chicken bedding from the chicken coop right behind me, in a way that didn't involve daily turning or constantly trying to keep the pile moist. And I have a fair volume of it, so I needed some sort of system that could handle volume. So I went with this idea of putting a bunch of my waste, organic waste, into these trash cans, occasionally wetting them down, both with water and urine, to add some nitrogen to them. And I like that idea for a few reasons. One, in Southern California, it's dry. We haven't gotten a lot of rain. So keeping a compost pile moist has been very hard. I have to tarp it and you have to wet it. If it's in a plastic vessel like this, then that inherently is going to hold the moisture in it. So I liked that idea of the system, and that's actually worked out really well. Now, one danger about the plastic is you can actually get it too wet. So I have had some too wet conditions where you get a lot of clumping, and at the bottom of these cans, they can get real, you know, muck-filled and kind of nasty smelling. They go anaerobic. Why I wanted to pursue this is because in the past, I had noticed that in a lot of nursery pots, I would get worms entering the nursery pots from the bottom. So I thought, well, what's a trash can? It's essentially a big nursery pot. I drilled holes in the bottom of each trash can to allow drainage, but also to allow the soil macroflora to come up through the soil into these cans. How has that worked? Well, it's okay. I can't exactly say how many worms are coming in. They're definitely not making their way to the top of the can. They could be at the bottom, and we'll explore the bottom of this can in this video. But that was the theory. It is providing drainage, and so those holes do serve a purpose. The anaerobic issue, given that there's not a lot of air moving through here, is that a problem? Honestly, I don't know. If this can smells, I don't really care. I keep the lid on it. It's downwind from my property. It's kind of in this area that's tucked away. So what? If it goes anaerobic for a little bit, so be it. It's not anaerobic. I don't think it's been anaerobic 52 weeks of the year since I started doing this. So if there's periods of it going anaerobic, so be it. It's still breaking down. The beauty of this method is it isn't really requiring a lot of work. I can just come by and dump stuff in these cans as I generate the waste. And then occasionally when I have excess water, I'll come and dump it. I tend to wash my hands outside into a bucket, so I catch all that hand wash water in a bucket, and I'll just dump that bucket into here to just continually hydrate these cans. I'll also come up, and it makes it a really nice, easy vessel to pee in to add nitrogen. Because one problem I have had, and I'll show you this in one of the cans, is the chicken bedding itself doesn't want to break down on its own. That's going to require an outside input to get it to effectively break down in this system. Now, you could probably compost chicken bedding really well in an aerobic, actively managed compost pile, but that's not what this is. This is a somewhat aerobic, more anaerobic, slow compost that isn't actively managed. My initial thought was, in chicken bedding, you have bedding, which is wood-based, and then you have chicken manure. So you get the poop and pee from the chicken that kind of comes out as one substance. I had thought there would be enough nitrogen in that to overcome the high amount of carbon in the bedding, but there isn't. There's just not enough. I think what's happening is a lot of the nitrogen in their excrement is volatilizing off, like in the form of ammonia. If you smell ammonia, that's nitrogen going up into the air. So I think while their pure excrement might have a really high nitrogen content, by the time that nitrogen volatilizes off and it dries in this bedding, there's just not a lot left. So I'll have a can back here that has chicken bedding, and it almost looks the same as when it went in. It's maybe a little darker in color, but it's not breaking down. So if I want to compost chicken bedding in something like this, I'm going to have to add a concentrated nitrogen source. Fish emulsion, blood meal, or even just poultry manure in a concentrate form, like say to the top, and then I would probably water it down so it would get to all the layers. So the composting of the bedding hasn't worked terribly great, but you know, it is what it is. One thing I have done is I've changed up my bedding that I'm using in my coop. I've tried to increase the amount of materials that I'm using in the bedding. They're all carbon-based, but I'm trying to vary the carbon source. So I use bagged bedding from Supply of Tractor Company. I also use straw for hay, whatever I can get cheaply, and then I've used rice hulls. And I kind of mix the three inside the coop just to give it a diversity of inputs when I go to compost it, because all the material coming out of that coop right there is going to go in my gardens or be used somewhere on the property. So I figure, why not have some diversity of inputs in the bedding so when I compost it, I have some more diverse sources. So long story short, this has worked pretty well. I've made some adjustments, and I'm going to show how I'm adjusting this system in the next video. But for now, let's take a look inside this can and see what it looks like. If we look into this can, which has been here for about a year, I believe, this is what the bottom of the can is now looking like. You can still identify a lot of leaf material. You still see the heavier pieces of wood because I have added some other bedding from underneath the coop, which gets this mulch brought into it, but it definitely has a soil-like texture. Now, I can identify the other bits of things in it. I can still see pieces of the tan bedding in here, but overall, pretty good work. I think this can has been here about a year. I should have put a date on it, but I didn't. So that's what this one looks like. Pretty good results. Now, is a preview to what's to come. One method I've changed over the last year is I'm now rotating these cans. I'm kind of transferring the contents from one can to the other, and I'm using the more finished cans to layer between new material in the new cans. Here's an example of a brand new can, or a newly filled and finished can, and I topped this with a layer of soil on top to kind of create a cap and introduce some biological activity that's in the soil to the can. One reason I'm layering the more finished compost into these new cans is because I'm trying to inoculate the cans and the materials with all the beneficial bacteria that are forming in the compost. So this is a brand new one. I'll explain this method in the next video. We've seen a successful can. Now let's look at a not so successful can. Here's a can that has predominantly chicken bedding in it. Now I've put some weeds and tomato prunings and things like that in here to try and add some more nitrogen to the mix. But this is what bedding looks like when you put it in a can. Even if you wet it, even if you pee on it, even with all the chicken manure in it, it tends to stay looking just like when you took it out of the coop. It's just not breaking down. The problem is this is wood-based, it's very high carbon. You're gonna need some fungal activity going on here to really break this down, or you really need to turn up the biological activity. And I do have a solution for that, or at least something I think will work, which I'll show you in a future video. So one of the ways I'm also trying to overcome this problem is by layering this material into the new cans as well. Because somebody suggested, well, you should just turn the cans. When these cans are heavy, they are very hard to manage. I mean, I'm not the lightest guy in the world, but I'm not the strongest guy in the world either. when they're wet, when they're full of material, they're very heavy and it's hard to just turn these cans over and dump them. So what I found makes it really easy is as I fill a new can, I take a shovel out of this can, I take a shovel out of another can, and I just kind of create layers in the new can and then just work my way around in kind of a system. So slowly I'm rotating the contents through the cans, but in a manageable way in terms of physical strength and exertion required. Here's what it looks like below the can. There's a little bit of worm activity. You can see all the drainage coming out. Here's another example of what it looks like below the can. And the can's been sitting here for a long time. There's a lot of roly-polies, bugs. And what's interesting is look at all these roots that are forming on this area. The roots and the plant are digging the lechate that's coming out of these cans. So it tells me, hey, there's something happening here. There's some promise. It just comes down to refining the system now. In summary, what are my thoughts about composting in trash cans? I think the system works okay, given the amount of effort that I'm putting in. I think there's room for refinement, and that's what I'm doing. I realize it's not a perfect system. I know there's better ways to compost, but again, it comes down to your context. What do you want to do? How much work do you want to put in? How much effort do you want to put in? How many inputs do you want to put in? This works for me. It can deal with the volume of bedding that I'm producing from my chicken coop. That's really the constraint here. I don't have a lot of kitchen waste. I have no yard waste whatsoever. So predominantly what's going into these cans is chicken bedding. So I'm trying to find a way to compost and reuse my chicken bedding in a garden system. So I'm designing the system or tinkering with the system to find a way to do that. It's still a work in progress, but as you saw, the soil kind of likes what's happening. Plants are digging what's happening in these cans. They like the lechate coming out of them. So promises here, continued work on this project, or work on this project continues into the future. In the next video, I'm going to show you how I fill one of these cans. And then in a future video, I'm going to show you how I've dealt with the too much bedding and the bedding not breaking down problem, and how I'm recycling that back into the garden and my chicken system. That's all for this one, everybody. Thanks for watching. Until next time, be nice, be thankful, and do the work.